had our GPCC working president, Shri Alexio Sequeira ji, our Mahila Congress president, Srimati Veena Naik, and our AACC observer for South Goa, Sunil Ramanavar, and our working president, our vice president, senior vice president, Mr. N.K. Sheikh, and our spokesperson, Mr. Tulio D'Souza. As you know, the Congress party has been vigorously getting our organization into shape, and we've been visiting all the blocks. Even yesterday, we had two successful with huge gatherings, two block Congress committee meetings in Ponda and Bicholim. The day before, in Navelim and in Novem and in Dabolim. Even the meeting in Novem was almost like a public meeting. And last evening in Bicholim also, though they say Bicholim is a tough seat for Congress, but the number of people who attended Bicholim meeting was almost 2,000 people had come. So our organization is getting battle ready, is battle ready. A lot of enthusiasm amongst our workers. And after the visit of Sri Rahul Gandhi ji, there's a greater sense of direction, purpose, and enthusiasm amongst the party. And even the people of Goa also, after the visit of Sri Rahul ji, there's a new focus on Congress and there's a lot of hope on Congress. Because Rahul ji very clearly and explicitly said that we will stand by the Goan people, we will fight for the causes of the Goan people, and whatever the many important issues that the Goan people have raised regarding the environment, regarding the coal hub issue, regarding the linear projects, regarding the mining issues, all those issues, the Congress will take up the stand which is the interest of Goa and which will protect the Goa's environment, culture, identity. So there's a lot of confidence amongst us. And as you know, the biggest issue that we face wherever we are going, and we are interacting with our workers, it's not just we are giving speeches, we are interacting with the workers. And most of the biggest issue that we are facing, and our workers are telling, our people of Goa are telling, people across India is telling, is that today the situation for the common man has become so difficult, so pathetic. The rise in prices of all commodities, I'm not talking only about petrol, diesel and LPG. You take your daily essentials, you take construction material, anything that is required for everybody on a regular basis, the prices have gone through the roof. It's unaffordable. Today to build a house, the cost of iron and cement and sand, everything is doubled. Your daily food grains and your food items, your cooking oil, your pulses and your basic ingredients, all have gone through the roof. And I don't have to tell you about petrol and diesel. Though it has been reduced now, the only reason why it got reduced was because in the by-elections, the BJP saw and felt the wrath of the people, and they saw the bad result that they got, and in reaction to that, they have taken this reduction to some extent of the petrol and diesel, but I feel that is not good enough. It can be further reduced to a much larger extent, and our demand is that LPG also should be reduced immediately to by minimum of 300 to 350 rupees, because they are profiteering. This government is profiting on the common man's stomach, on his common man's earning. They're not taxing the rich, they're not taxing the big people, but they're taxing the common people, the poor farmer, the daily worker, the laborer, the small businessman, the person who doing small jobs. Everybody's suffering. So on that issue, we have decided that the Congress party will take this issue throughout the state of Goa. And we are launching a campaign called Margaicho Jagor. Margaicho Jagor.
Margaicho
Jagor. We are launching that program. I'll show it to you. We are launching that program. And this will be the campaign slogan. You can see.
It's okay.
So this campaign will be launched from this November 18th onwards, and it will be a 5-day program. 18th, 19th, 20th, 21st, 22nd. For 5 days, we have formed 9 groups, 9 senior leaders. Along with them, each leader will have a team, and they will visit all the constituencies of Goa for 5 days. Each group will have been given 3 to 4 constituencies each, and they will go around these constituencies highlighting these issues, telling people of the failure of the BJP government, and to pressurize, to build public opinion so that the government will take further actions to reduce the prices of all these commodities and all these daily essential services that people need. So this program will be launched not in one particular place. Each person, like Mr. Digambar Kamath, Mr. Girish Chodankar, Mr. Alexio Sequeira, Mr. Reginaldo Sardine, Mr. Khala, we made a list. Mr. Sangeeta Parab, each one will have one team, and they will go from morning to night in every constituency. They will go meet the people, they will do padyatras, they will address small groups, small gatherings, and tell the people of Goa that how BJP, this corrupt government, this government which is ineffective in handling the economy of the country and handling the economy of the state, today it's bankrupt, does not have money, and how the common man is suffering because of the incorrect policies, flawed policies, and wrong decisions. So the people of India, the people of Goa are bearing the brunt of this. So I'll be releasing, I'll be giving you the note on this, that who are the leaders. I can just read it out to you if you want. Okay, anyway, I read it to you, Mr. Kalap and all the people. I'll release you the list of all the 9 leaders and the groups and the constituencies that they've been given in charge. So this is basically what we've come to tell you, and to announce this program. So any other questions you have, you can ask me.
GFP has said that on 19 December they will going to announce their manifesto and the contours of the next government based on the alliance with Congress. So do
you... Who has said?
GFP.
They are holding a meeting on 19th, saying that they are holding a meeting with next cabinet. So will be a Congress part of it?
No, I don't know about that. I don't know, this is our program, so I don't know what he's announcing. I have no information on this announcement.
But what is the present status or anything, is Congress on this alliance issue? I don't know, so whether it will happen or what?
See, I've already told you before that the most important thing for Goa is that Goa needs to be freed of this corrupt and communal government. We need to free Goa from this government, of this Goa government. BJP government. You have to remove them. That is the number one priority. And to do that, the Congress party is working day and night. We are working in a systematic manner, and we are going around the state, visiting all the blocks and energizing our party workers and reaching out to the people. At the same time, I have also told, and we have also told, that we are open for having an alliance with people who understand Goa, who are from this soil, who identify with the Goan culture, Goan community, and who stand for the shared values of the Congress party. So for that, definitely, we will be open for that, because our main thing is to see that this government should go. this, we need to see that 10 years of this misrule should end. And for that, we are open to having discussions and
having alliance. People are having alliance to go forward like my neighbor.
See, alliance with, I've said before, alliance with people, alliance with political parties, we are open for that. We are discussing. We are in discussions with some people. But ultimately, the main aim should be, how do we bring about a good, stable government for Goa, which can rule for 5 years and cleanse this 10 years of destruction that has taken place, and give a good government, and which can build the state.
We know exactly what is you are saying. You are doing
same things.
Tell us what is about the situation right now.
See, how can I tell the situation?
Alliance.
See, when I say that we are open for it and we are having some discussions, but whenever I cannot announce anything here till something is finalized.
We are hardly 2-3 months.
See, we are a political party. We are the ones who are going to go for elections. We also understand what is time management, time factors, all those things. We also are equally as keen as you are. We are also very keen to see that all these things are done in a proper manner. But everything,
tomorrow if alliance takes place,
see, we cannot have alliances based on when there is no proper alignment. An alliance should take place with a proper alignment.
So there is no proper
alignment. Like last time, the alliances didn't have a proper alignment. So last time, we can't repeat those mistakes. If you do something, it should be done properly and correctly.
How long will it take?
The mistakes of the past should not be repeated.
Fine.
And we should do it in a proper manner.
Fine. But how long will it take for...
See, now that is not for me to tell. But we will take a decision at the right time after everything is aligned properly.
Any deadline?
I can't, there's no personal deadline or anything.
Congress looking for a limited alliance or a mega alliance?
See, Congress party has got its own strength. So we can contest all 40 seats also. Mm-hmm. But at the same time, we understand that our first aim is to see that BJP government goes. So we are working it in different ways. Let us see how it happens. So I cannot say major, minor, all that. We are the main party. We are the opposition party. We are the party which is going to form the government the next election, after the elections are over. We are the principal opposition. So we are the major part of Goa. And Congress has ruled Goa. It's not that we've never ruled Goa. So
can we say that whatever decisions are proposed may be, but
I told very clearly, simply saying the same thing again and again. You're trying to bring something out of this whole thing.
Your potential alliance partners, they have already declared candidates in certain constituencies. So how will it work later?
See, when elections are announced, candidates should be announced. Today, there are prospective candidates, there are interested candidates, there are aspirants. All those things are there in politics.
But they are accusing.
And then there are some within Congress also in some seats where there are 2-3 people trying for the same within Congress itself. So that exists.
But I
can't comment on other political parties what they want to do. I don't know whether anyone has announced candidates officially that this is the candidate signed on the letter. Nobody has done that. Orally, people saying that is different. But till the elections are announced, nobody is going to announce candidates.
सर बीजेपी एमएलए और अदरवाइज रूलिंग एमएलए लोगों ने कांग्रेस पार्टी को कुछ अप्रोच किया है सर ज्वाइन करने के लिए
सी देयर आर इन पॉलिटिक्स देयर इज ऑलवेज पीपल डिस्कसिंग बट व्हाट हाउ सीरियस दिस डिस्कशंस आर व्हाट हैपेंस आई कैन नॉट मेक एनी कमेंट राइट नाउ
कांटेक्ट तो है सर कांटेक्ट हुआ है
सी आई डोंट वांट टू स्पेकुलेट ऑन ऑल दिस थिंग्स बिकॉज़ दीस आर ऑल वेरी स्पेकुलेटिव टॉक्स and simply it gets unnecessary prominence. When something will happen, it will happen and you will come to know. That's the only thing I can say.
Check kitna figure bol sakte sir, kitna log contact hai
you. So I can't make those comments. No, that is not correct for me to say all those things.
So yesterday RG has aligned with Swaraj party. From Swaraj, how do you look at it, sir?
See, each political party has got its own, I would say, their own plans. So it's for them to do what they want. I will not want to comment upon some other political party how they want to do their election. Last time there was a hype about another political party. It was supposed to sweep. So all these, you know, hype and publicity, ultimately on ground, how much it converts, I have no clue. I don't know.
No, sir.
So why speculate about something which we don't even really know what is that strength is?
Recently, Kunsa was member, Captain Virato, met your Congress leaders like P. Chidambaram and Girish and GP together. What is that?
See, Captain Virato is a good friend of ours. And he's been, and we support him in his causes, definitely. He's doing good work. He has met us and spoken to us on many issues. So, I mean, if he's trying to do something, I think, I mean, I'm not going to make any comment on that. But he's doing it in the interest of Goa, I think. He's trying to see that this BJP government should go. So,
sir, can I ask you,
yeah,
coming back to this question, you spoke about last 2017 election of National Party, which came here and proved blank.
Yeah.
But are you aware of regional party performing better? So you were asking about regional party.
Yeah, so it's untested.
So
untested, no? So how do we know anything?
Last election, one test.
So why give some, when we don't know what is their strength, if they're one, you know, if they contested elections and won elections and if they had a ground support, then we can comment. Now we don't know anything about them. It's all speculation. So why should I worry about something which is so speculative?
I was little late. I just wanted to know, with whom are you discussing?
No, that I think we already have. You can ask your colleagues. No, they will tell you what I said.
You have not told us.
Can you repeat?
We have not mentioned to whom you are discussing.
Yes, yes, yes.
Can you repeat?
No, I will not say all
this. MGP,
NCP.
See, we are in discussion with people with parties who they have spoken to us.
Who are they?
Who are the regional parties of Goa? NCP is there, MGP is there, Goa Forward is there. All of them are, they are in discussion with us because all of them are feeling that this BJP government is, has to go. But ultimately, like I said, an alliance requires a proper alignment.
Sir,
that I don't know. That has to play out properly.
How long is it going to take to elect PMs?
I cannot say. Anything.
Are you in discussion with the NCP? You said, are they regional?
Who?
The NCP?
NCP is a well established party. It's been there for a long time. It's not a fly by night operator.
You said regional, that's why I asked.
I didn't say regional. But some of them have got built up a regional. Now, Congress is a national party, BJP is a national party, but we have regional strong presence because we have done work for Goa, no? Congress has done work for Goa. Congress has been part of Goa's so many movements. So that in that way, Congress may be a national party, but it's a regional, local strength. What I meant when I say regional, it should be also, as I said earlier, you were not there. You should understand the Goa's culture, identity and reflect that. That is important. Okay.
So yesterday, CM said 10,000 job promises will be fulfilled before the election. How do you look at it?
See, after 10 years, after promising lakhs of jobs, in the last few months before election, you want to hurriedly give them jobs, shows how they're using even this to get the vote. They've not bothered. They should have given these jobs much earlier, no? 1 year back, 2 years back, 3 years back, 5 years back. Why this? So they're saying, I'll give you a job, you give me the vote. So it shows absolute bankruptcy of the BJP. The desperation of the BJP. Because they know that they're losing this election. Within their own party, there are so much of divisions. Many of their parties, people don't even want to contest on BJP, our PC president has told. No? Many of them don't want to contest on BJP, simple. That's also happening today.
So your 2017 president and was also a strategist for party, joined another party, TMC now. Will that affect Congress?
See, that is an old story, no? That time only I have reacted. For why should we again make a comment now?
So what are your views on the Kejriwal? Because one month ne do teen baar to visit kar rahe Goa mein, just kya lagta
hai? Every political party has got a right to do their work, but they should do it in a proper manner. They should do it for the sake of Goa, not to just win an election. Now they are coming and promising different things, which is not correct. I don't think a political party should say, I'm going to make this community person CM, this community person deputy CM. That is not a right approach. That is, you're trying to use caste as a way of getting votes. How? That means you're part of, you're the same as BJP. You're a communal casteist party. You're saying deputy CM have given to certain community, Catholic community, and CM have given. So you're asking votes based on casteism and communalism. So how different are you from BJP? So it proves that he's a B team of BJP. Thank you.